Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and cardaholics of all ages, welcome to my channel. This is my first video. I'm so excited to be doing this, to be joining the world of YouTube and to be joining the card collecting community in this way. My name is Alex. I will be your guide on this journey through collecting. And in my first video, I want to tell you a little about my collections, and I wanted to show off my top 10 from 2020. 2020 was quite a year, as I'm sure you're all aware. We've had a lot of ups and a lot of downs, and that's true in the collecting hobby as well. Sports cards just went crazy. Gary V says some things, and then you can't find anything on the shelves anymore. But despite that, you know, it's nice to see everybody's collections. It's nice to be a part of this. So I wanted to highlight my top 10 purchases, pulls, you name it, my cards of 2020 that I was really excited to add to my collection. I do baseball primarily. I do a little bit of wrestling, a little bit of football, a little bit of basketball, nothing crazy. If it's football or basketball, it's primarily guys that I kind of just grew up with or I just like. Baseball, I'm a big Yankees fan. So sorry if that turns you off. Allen and Ginter autographs are definitely my favorite too. I love the frame, especially the non-sport. Big fan of those. And I do wrestling, big WWE fan as well. So without any further ado, I do have two honorable mention cards that I just wanted to show off because I can, because it's my channel and I can do what I want, but I just wanted to include them because I feel like they're just really special. And I think you've all seen this card enough times. Jason Dominguez, first Bowman from 2020 Bowman. He's just going to explode. I mean, he already caused a big disturbance in the hobby earlier this year. When Bowman came out, and it was impossible to find on the shelves. I opened up so much Bowman, I couldn't get him. Like, I got a couple first edition packs paper. I could not find a chrome, so I just paid to have a chrome. I've considered getting it graded, but at the same time, he's 17. You don't know how he's going to do. I hope he does well, because I don't want anybody to not do well in their career. I want him to flourish. It helps he's a Yankee, but we'll see. Time will tell on Dominguez, but he's an honorable mention. Another honorable mention for me as well is this. This is a 2019 Bowman Chrome Tim Tebow Gold Refractor, number 9 out of 50. Christian school kid here, and Tim Tebow is one of those names you just hear all the time. I thought it was just a nice little novelty item, so had to pick it up. So, here we go. Number 10. 2020 Allen and Ginter autograph of Kelsey Cook. She is a hilarious comedian, world champion foosball player. And as soon as I saw that she was going to be in the checklist, I had to pick this up. I got a hobby box of Ginter, did not pull an autograph, so I paid for this. Well worth it. I am now working on the Ginter Chrome Rainbow for Kelsey Cook. So if anybody has any, let me know. Specifically the red refractor, super refractor. Any base, I've got a green, gold, orange incoming, but I'm almost there already. So if you got any Kelsey Cook, let me know. Number 9 is a 2020 Bowman Sapphire Everson Pereira autograph. I unfortunately could not get past the bots with Bowman Sapphire. I tried for, oh gosh, hours trying to get Bowman Sapphire while I was at work. Don't tell my boss. And I couldn't get it. So I watched, this is one of the guys I wanted that I figured I could afford. I figured he's a good investment. Everson Pereira for the Yankees. And I picked it up off of eBay for pretty decent price. So pretty happy with that. Really wanted to hang on to this because I feel like, you know, if you can make an investment in first Bowman, stick with it. I've got a few of this guy's autographs. I feel like he's going to be good, but time will tell. Like Jason Dominguez. Number 8 is 2020 Topps Archives Phil Hughes Auto. I love Phil. I love Phil's channel, Phil's polls. Give that a watch if you haven't already. Phil's great. I grew up watching Phil. So to be a part of his channel, be a subscriber, and hearing he had archives, I bought as many archives fat pack as I could, and I finally pulled this myself. So it was really neat to add this specific card to my collection. I got a collection of Phil stuff, so this was really neat. Addition to that, number 7 is a 2020 Topps Chrome Yordan Alvarez Purple Rookie Card, 28 out of 299. I paid $25 for this a couple weeks ago. I felt like I just robbed a bank. Like, I feel like this is the steal of the century. If he comes back from his knee surgery and he rakes like he did in 2019, this car is going to explode in value. And alongside that, with number six, is his Topps Chrome Auto. I picked this up off of eBay for, again, a really nice price. This, if he can come back healthy, both of those cars, really anything Jordan, are going to be just through the roof. So really, really was happy to add this to my collection. For now, we'll see what happens. Number five, Luis Robert was a big hobby name this year, and he started out hot, obviously cooled down a little bit. Back before the whole craze with sports cards started, I was at Meijer, and I picked up a blaster of 2020 Gypsy Queen, and I happened to pull a redemption for this bad boy. It is a 2020 Gypsy Queen Luis Robert rookie autograph. It's not numbered, no variation or anything like that, but as soon as I saw the redemption, I knew I didn't have Miles Michaelis, I didn't have Max Scherzer, although I would have appreciated them, I had Luis Robert. So this is not going anywhere for a while. I'm super happy to have this in my collection. I'm really hoping he comes back strong. I really hope he becomes the star that we all project him to be. I know everyone's like, he's the next Mike Trout. I hope he is. I really do. Number four is this Alexa Bliss signature from 2019, WWE Undisputed. I love Alexa Bliss. I had to have this. I don't think I need to go into any further detail than that. So really, really happy to have this in the collection. Number three, I do a little bit of Pokemon, and a little bit of background on this. I did Pokemon when I was a kid. I stopped as I got older, and I felt like there was just a big craze about it right now. Everyone's going for Rainbow Rare Charizards and everything. So I thought, you know what? I'll just pick up a pack, and I'll just see what happens. I had a buddy who was getting back into Pokemon cards too, so I said, let's just go for it. Why not? My first pack, it was Vivid Voltage, and I pulled this. This is the Rainbow Rare Pikachu VMAX that, if a PSA 10 would sell for right now about $1,500, give or take. I was shocked. And like, this is my first pack back in. So now they've pulled me back in because, of course, they have. Now, the only downside to this one is it is a little bit off center, top to bottom. I'm still going to submit it for grading because maybe they'll give me an OC grade that's off center. It could be a 9 and it still sells for a good bit. Well, it's not the only one I have. I have two. I pulled this one from Meijer and this one from Target. So two Rainbow Rare Pikachu VMAXs. And this one right here is absolutely pristine. I think it's a lot better centering-wise. Maybe a little off, but I mean, it's barely noticeable. It's great condition, great corners, great edges, beautiful surface. This, I hope, when I submit it, will be a PSA 10. For sure. So I love Pikachu. Really, really excited to have these. These probably will not stay in the collection long. Got a wedding coming up and, you know, got to pay for some stuff. But really cool to pull this to get back in the hobby. Number two, I got for Christmas actually from my grandma. And a little bit of background on this too. I grew up in Chicago and Carrie Wood was a household name for me. So I loved watching Carrie Wood. Loved, loved, loved watching Carrie Wood. And my grandma, for this Christmas this year, she decided to get me the Carrie Wood autograph from 2020 Ellen and Ginter. Now, I don't think she knew that I love Ellen and Ginter framed autographs that much. Like, I love the way that these look. They're just stunning. Big fan of Ellen and Ginter. It's one of my favorite products. To make it Carrie Wood really just added some huge sentimental value to this card. This card's never going anywhere. I'm a big believer in sentimental stuff, and this just really meant a lot to me. It was a great Christmas present. So Carrie Wood autograph is number two. Number one is a huge PC hit for me that I finally was able to get, and I just have to show it to you. It's not the most valuable card in the world. Probably doesn't beat Luis Robert, Jordan Alvarez. But to me, this is everything. This is my only Aaron Judge autograph from 2016 Bowman Inception. I love Aaron Judge. I know he's injured all the time. He's a stand-up dude. He's a great player when he's healthy. He's one of the leaders of my Yankees. And I've got a huge Aaron Judge collection, but I didn't have an autograph for the longest time. So to be able to add this, I traded. I traded a Pete Alonso 2020 Heritage Red Ink autograph for this and a couple other things. I think a Noah Syndergaard auto was in there too. So this was a huge trade for me, but it was a huge deal to finally add Aaron Judge's autograph to my collection. So 2020, as I mentioned, was absolutely insane in the hobby. I mean, you have flippers everywhere. You can barely find anything. I hope 2021 gets better. I think that we're in just a really booming period in sports cards, and it's exciting. It's nerve-wracking to go to Targets and never find anything, but if you can get there and you can get what you want, you can buy singles, just have fun. It's so exciting to see the hobby booming like it is, and we're getting spoiled by companies. We're getting release after release after release, and it's awesome on one hand. It can be a little oversaturating at times, but it's really exciting to be part of these hobbies, and I'm super excited for what 2021 holds. I'm so excited to share my pulls with you, my cards with you, as I pick up stuff. I'll be sure to open them on camera for you guys, leave some reviews, talk about some products, show off some more PC stuff. So leave a like, comment, subscribe if you're interested in joining me on this journey. I'm so excited to be starting this YouTube journey with you guys, and I cannot wait to see you guys in the next video. We will see you then. Bye-bye.